Afternoon baseball on the show as you get a look there at Rogers Center in Toronto. Today, the finale of this quick two-game series between the Philadelphia Phillies and the Toronto Blue Jays. It's Blue Jays baseball, and it's on its way next. Daniel Norris, a southpaw from Tennessee, is the man on the mound. EK, what's the word on him?
Well, guys, he's been what you would call a fourth or fifth starter. Got a career ERA of over four, but he will give you innings, and he is dependable.
Ben Revere heads for the box, ready to lead this one off today.
Philadelphia left fielder, Ben Revere.
Line toward right center. Solid base hit for him, his first of the afternoon.
Oh, you better have to pay attention to this guy right now. He is heating it up. Seven straight games now with that hit.
Drew Stubbs.
Now to the plate, Drew Stubbs, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. First offering on its way. High and deep to right center field. Green racing back, but he's not going to get this one. It's into the gap. Around third and being waved on home. And they're going to take a 1-0 lead as the run comes across to score.
Well, that didn't take long. You get the leadoff single to start off the game, and then you follow that up with a two-base hit. They're already on the scoreboard, and we haven't even had a chance to sit down yet.
Michael Franco will get his first opportunity here, currently leading the league in two of the three Triple Crown categories.
Boy, just an amazing season he's had so far, and he's in the top five in average. Maybe he can get enough hits to push himself into that number one spot.
Heading out towards shallow right, Mendoza over to his left. Oh, what happened there? It falls in. Around third and being waved on home. The runner scores from second, and he will make it all the way to third now as that mistake proves a costly one indeed.
Oh, this one really hurts. You don't mind seeing this quite as much with the bases empty, but this one's going to cost him a run.
Stepping in now, Darren Ruff, as he'll go after the first pitch to him and comes up empty. It's strike one. And Eric, the Blue Jays, as they enter play here this afternoon, it was another loss for them last time out, and that makes them 2-8 over their last 10 games.
And they're in need of a good pitching performance here just to shake them out of this slump they're in. They've won just once in five games on this current homestand, so they're definitely going in the wrong direction.
One and two as the changeup had him out in front there. Still no fastballs in the at-bat. It's been all off speed.
That's definitely by design. He's such a good fastball hitter. You don't want to give in to his strength.
A ball and two strikes. Here's the pitch.
Ball two.
A little low. It's two and two. Time for a look at the umpires working this one. Behind the plate is Darryl Parker.
Well, Matt, Darryl, he can have that moving strike zone at times. He calls a pretty good game overall, but I know people aren't always sure what he likes.
Out in front of that one, may have been looking fastball. Good job just to make contact. He's set. Here's the 2-2. Smoke toward the hole. And that'll get on through into right field for a base hit. And to score is the runner from third. It's a 3-0 game.
Batting fifth, third baseman
Adrian Beltre will get his first opportunity now. 14 home runs to his credit so far this year. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Line drive to left. Saunders is right there as he puts it away, no problem for the first down. Time now for a glance at the Phillies batting order in this one. Who's the one to watch, EK?
Well, if you're on the mound, you better be careful with Michael Franco. He comes into this one following a huge 7 RBI game. And hopefully he didn't spend all his run producing chips in one place. We'll see if he saved any more for this one.
Salvador Perez is in to take his first swings here with the runner still at first and one away.
Well, too bad that last guy couldn't advance the man into scoring position, so now it's probably going to take a gapper to get him home.
Sends that one out of play for strike one. And boy, they're really giving him fits inside now as he can't get extended there, and it's 0-2 now. Way outside. 1-2.
That changeup away is his ground ball pitch. That's a good job to hold off.
Fly ball out toward left center field. Saunders is after it, but he won't get there. It falls in. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double.
Well, that base hit is going to get his hit streak to six games now, so he's swinging it.
Brock Holt will stand in as he'll get a break from playing the field and be the DH here in this one.
Yeah, it's a nice luxury to have here in an interleague ballgame. You give him a little bit of a break from the field, but you still keep that big bat in the lineup.
Hard hit ball to second, but right to the second baseman, and that's the second out. With a moment now, let's give you a look at the defensive alignment for the Blue Jays. It's brought to us by Majestic. Eric, what do we need to know?
Well, guys, Josh Donaldson is an MVP type player because of his offense, but his defense is just as superb. He makes great plays, very athletic, and some of the things he does on a baseball field, you just can't imagine. I can't wait to watch him.
First pitch of the at-bat. Oh, that ball's driven into left center. This could be trouble. And he dives to make a spectacular catch. What a play there to end the inning. One more look at the full extension catch that strands two men on the base paths. We're back to Toronto after this. Chris Acho is on the mound for game two. Eric, any thoughts?
Well, guys, he's having a very nice season so far. You look at that ERA in the low twos. Looking to continue that trend here in this one.
Right back to work as the shortstop, Jose Reyes, digs in to lead off the bottom of inning number one.
The shortstop, Jose Reyes.
Now a swing and a miss. Took something off that one, and it's strike one. Eric, these Phillies, as they begin play here today, they've been on a real nice run of late, winning five of their last six games.
Not only have they been playing well, but they've got their ace going here this afternoon, so the rich get richer.
From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Off-speed pitch in the dirt as he takes it for a ball.
He's come at him with all off-speed stuff so far, but if I'm at the plate, if I'm hidden, I'm thinking he's going to have to throw a fastball here sooner or later.
Swung on, and he went fishing in the dirt. And he makes the throw to first. Reyes is retired, and there's one away. With that, let's take a look at the Blue Jays starting lineup. Steve, how did they bounce back and avoid the dreaded sweep?
Down by three after the top of the first, you're already in a big hole. So almost every guy in your lineup becomes a leadoff hitter. Get those guys on to start innings and see if you can get a rally going.
Everett Cabrera will stand in now, just a few ticks shy of the 300 mark for the season. Good late break to the slider here, but he takes it in on the hands for ball one. Oh, and he had him guessing there, and it's a ball and a strike.
Yeah, I don't think you want to come in throwing a lot of high changeups. That's a pitch he's going to have to get lower in the strike zone.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Well, this is a guy up there that's not hitting a ton right now, but he can still work the count, and that alone can be beneficial to an offense.
Oh, not cheated on that one. It's 2-2.
Boy, when he's got that thing going good, it just takes a nosedive right at the end.
And a fastball blew it right by him, and there are two down. And with that, let's take a look at how the Phils will set up on D. It's brought to us by Majestic. EK, what do you got?
Well, guys, remember, this manager has not jumped on board with all the defensive shifts. Still that old-school mentality, plays guys straight up. So we'll see how that impacts this game.
Edwin Encarnacion will stand in, and you see what he's done over the past four games, as hot as they come. Here's the first pitch slider that just tails out of the zone. It's ball one. A little bouncer. That's a foul ball. Bases are empty here with two men out. And he takes a called strike two.
Boy, it's only the third batter here, but he's been impressive so far. He's looking like he's going to be pretty tough to beat.
Threw it right past him. A swing and a miss at the gas, and that ends the inning. Three up, three down, three strikeouts. Not too shabby. We're back to Rogers Center following this break. Brandon Jordan will get his first shot here. A couple of hits in four trips last night.
Well, yesterday he just kept things rolling. You know, he's had eight RBIs in his last 10 games. I got to take that.
Swing and a miss as he was way in front of that one. And it's quickly 0-2. And here's a slider that runs inside that time, and that'll keep him from diving out over the plate.
I think he was trying to get that slider in on his hands, but I don't think he meant for it to get in that far. I think he just released it a little too late.
And he'll try to get him fishing there, but he won't offer in the dirt, and it's back to even at 2-2.
I smell another changeup coming here before too long.
Could even be right here.
Full count, 3-2.
Yeah, and that's not the pitch you want to throw on 2-2. I mean, that was so high, he didn't even have to think about swinging at it.
Hits it high and deep out to center field. Green ranging back. Gone! So it's a solo shot to dead center, and even 20 home runs for him now thus far, as the Phillies have opened things up now 4-0.
And about the only silver lining to this one from a defensive standpoint is the fact that it came with the bases empty leading off an inning. So you can survive it when this guy's hitting just solo shots. It's when he's doing his damage with two or three guys on base that things can really get out of hand in a hurry.
Now batting.
Here's Ben Revere.
Ben Revere.
Oh, he looks like he's swinging a garden hose out there as this is cut on and missed for strike one.
That's such a good pitch to get ahead. Lefty on lefty. It's a big looping curveball. Makes it very difficult for the hitter to try and time what's coming next.
Not able to hold on there as he swings through a pitch in the dirt, and it doesn't look good for him now, down 0-2.
Yeah, he was out front right there, probably guessing fastball. But now, 0-2, you can't be guessing anymore. You got to find something in the strike zone and put it in play.
Ready to deliver the 1-2. A bit low. Tough call, but it's 2-2.
And again, they try to take him down in the strike zone just to see if he'll go after that pitch below the knees. But with two strikes, he's been able to lay off that thing now twice in a row.
He gets dirty, but he can't get there, and it's into center field.
Boy, the hits just keep on coming here. You see the highlighted column right there. That's six against him already, and we're just in the second inning.
Drew Stubbs stands in after hitting an RBI double his first time around.
And with a man on first, it'll take at least another double to bring him in.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Swinging a soft liner. Coming on is Sanders, but he won't get there. It's a base hit.
But now the pitching coach is going to come in and have a word with him. And in the second inning, now once he makes sure he's okay physically, he'll be saying, hey, look, let's put all that's just happened behind us and focus on the task at hand.
At the plate, Michael Franco. He reached base on an error and later came around to score last time up.
Yeah, still looking for his first hit of the game, so let's see if he can come through with that one right here.
This is line to left. Saunders has to retreat a bit, but he gets there for out number one. And Saunders' throw is late as he'll make it into third safely.
Good job there at second base of doing the math in his head and figuring out he can make it up to third. So that puts runners on the corners now with only one away.
Digging in to try it again, Darren Ruff. He came through with an RBI single in his last at-bat.
Well, and everyone knows he's slumping right now, so we'll see if that got him going.
A little tardy there. No balls and a strike.
Doing a good job right there of tying him up inside. Got in on his hands that time before he could get that barrel through the zone.
And boy, this at-bat is not starting off well as he's behind 0-2 now.
Yeah, that's in a great spot, too. Just hard, late movement working down and in.
Left field and deep. Looking up is Saunders. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. So a three-run blast to straightaway left. Eighth home run on the season for him as this lead swells to 7-0.
Wow. He has proven to be a real nuisance in the first two games of this series. A home run in last night's ball game, and now another one here.
And now the Blue Jays get a left-hander up and throwing in their bullpen. Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. As he's first pitch swinging here, and this is on the ground toward the hole. And just past his outstretched glove into left, a base hit.
Boy, they are really sticking it to him right here. That's the fifth hit he's coughed up in this inning alone, and you got to believe that that leash is getting a little bit shorter with each passing batter.
In now, Salvador Perez. He'll try to follow up the double in his last at-bat with another big hit right here.
Yeah, it's been an offensive explosion for him today, and let's see if they can keep it going.
Here's the first pitch to him. And a ball, 1-0.
And this is a guy that needs to throw that curveball for strikes.
Yeah, when he doesn't have command on it, that's when he has to lean on his fastball. And sometimes that'll get him in trouble.
High in the air, carrying well out to deep center. Green going back to the track. He gets there, and that's the second out.
And, you know, these guys already have two home runs in the game, and they darn near just got their third one here. But that ball just kind of ran out of steam just shy of the wall.
Here's Brock Holt now. Pitch swung on and hit in the air. Saunders on the move. But he won't have a play. This is down and into the gap. So now they'll have two men in scoring position following the two-out double.
Boy, he has really taken a pounding out there. That's six hits now he's given up in just this inning alone. And it's beyond time for a change. You've got to get him out of there.
So now the Jays manager will make his way out toward the mound. And it would appear he's seen enough of his starter this afternoon. So he'll exit here this afternoon to more than a handful of boos, I'm sure, after what can only be described as a terrible pitching performance. Mark Burley is going to come on now here in just a second inning, so he'll likely be asked to work a few innings here.
Mark Burley.
Freddie Galvis will be his first assignment as he steps in with two men in scoring position now, but also two away. On the ground to third. And how about that right out of the bullpen? A ground ball on one pitch, and the inning is over. Nine men come to the plate, four score. On now to the bottom of the second. It's the Phillies 7, the Jays nothing. Adam LaRoche will lead things off here with his guys down 7 in the early going. Steve Lyons, how do you come back from a deficit like that?
Well, I think slowly. I mean, yeah, ideally a 10-run inning would be great. But you've got time on your side. You don't need to try to get it all back at once. Just peck away. A couple runs here, a couple runs there. Get yourself into slam range. That's 4 runs down.
And he'll fall behind now to 1-2. Grounded up the first baseline. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 1-2. Chopped foul at the plate. It'll remain 1-2. Here's the 1-2 delivery. Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
Well, pitching like this deserves another look through as we check out the last 4 batters on Showtrap. Here he was striking out the side the previous inning, and he starts things off here with another one. That's 4 in a row now.
Josh Donaldson will stand in for the first time now, coming off a 3-hit contest in the loss last night. And he lays off there 1-0. Bases are empty, 1 man out. Donnie couldn't pull that one back as he clearly broke the plane of the plate, and that'll be ruled a strike. That changed things up on him, and he got him to swing through it 1-2 now.
We're already at 4. Do I hear 5 strikeouts in a row?
Set to deal on a ball and 2 strikes. Swing and a little tapper, but that one rolls foul. Boy, and they cannot touch him right now. 5 straight strikeouts on the ledger, and there are 2 away.
Yeah, he's feeling it out there now. I mean, that is 5 straight guys that he struck out now. His defenders may as well come on into the dugout and take a break because they're not even needed out there now.
Deonner Navarro strides forward for the first time, and he's been in a bit of a slump recently. Up and in for ball 1. And a strike to even the count. 1-1. 2 out, nobody on. A ball and 2 strikes to count now with the bases empty and 2 away. Down the third baseline, fielded by Beltre. Throw on to first, gets him, and the side is retired. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. They need to get something cooking here. It's 7-0. A nice daytime shot there from one of the many marinas here in Toronto as we're set to go in the 3rd inning of this one. Brandon Jordan steps in here to start out their half of the 3rd, top of the order to follow.
Yeah, and you know, he's the number 9 hitter, but you've got to go to the plate right now thinking like a leadoff guy.
There's a swing and a ball hit in the air, and a ball that he got every stitch of, as that one, without a doubt, is gone. A solo shot here to left. His 2nd of the game, as they've widened this lead to 8 now.
That pitcher's got to be thinking, how can I throw a pitch like that in this situation? That thing was so right down the middle, it absolutely got hammered, and he knew it as soon as he let go of it.
Here's Ben Revere.
Ben Revere.
A shot down the first baseline. And he'll take this to the bag. 3 unassisted for the first out.
Well, I think he got away with one right there. I mean, this is a fastball right down the middle. And he just smokes this ball, too. But unfortunately, he hits it right at someone. So it becomes a fairly easy out.
Drew Stubbs digs in with one run in and one gone in the inning. Chop fouled over towards the coaching box. Burley looks in. Here it is on 0-1. Not the greatest at bat thus far, as he misses that pitch in the dirt and falls behind nothing and two now.
One thing you've got to be aware of as a hitter is he's going to give you a bit of a variety up there. He's got five pitches, and he's going to use all of them.
Line toward the alley in left center, and he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
The minute he hits that, he's thinking it's a base hit all the way, but this is one of those situations where, you know, you get penalized for hitting the ball too hard. And this stayed up long enough to find the outfielder's glove out there.
Standing in now, Michael Franco, as he lines this one out to center. And that finds some outfield grass. It's a base hit.
Oh, and he botches it.
Darren Ruff strides forward to bat again, coming off a home run that plated three scores in his last appearance.
Well, it was a two-strike breaking ball that he hit out of here, so we'll see if they go a different direction if they get him to two strikes again.
Sent on the ground out to second. He's got it. Throw on to LaRoche takes care of him, and with that, the side is retired. But the Phils tack on one more on this solo home run. We play 2.5. It's the Phillies 8, the Jays nothing. Victor Mendoza will come forward to begin the inning. 7-8 and 9 to start the home third.
They're still searching for a base runner. It's been six up, six down to start the game.
And he gets ahead with the curveball. Strike one. Swing and a ball chopped foul right at home plate. Chopped foul at the plate, and he stays alive, still 0-2. The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
All right, so he sort of wasted one up right there. Now I think we'll see a breaking ball down in the zone trying to get him to swing and miss.
And a swing and a miss as he picks up yet another strikeout. Six of them already, and there's one gone in the inning. Well, it's still early, but it's also worth noting that he'd be in line for the win if this keeps up, as we take a look at the league leaders in games won this season. And as you see, he's right up there among league leaders in that department. And he starts the number 8 hitter with a strike, nothing and one.
I tell you, he's got a good pace, a good tempo to him out there right now.
High and deep to straightaway right. Jordan racing back. Now a leaping effort at the wall, but he comes up empty. This one is gone. Home run. A solo shot here to straightaway right field. Sixth home run on the season for him. And they're now on the board, though still well behind.
Well, with the hole that they dug themselves here early in the ballgame, it's definitely going to be a long road back. But we've seen stranger things happen. And who knows? Maybe we'll look back on this home run as the one shot that got the huge comeback started.
Harold Green will stand in for the first time. And he's seen that average climb during his current 7-game hitting streak. Curveball just misses, apparently. 1-0.
He wanted to go after that one, but that's a good eye to just watch it all the way in.
Perhaps a little low there. It's 2-0. Outside, 3-0 now. There's Jose Reyes. He waits on deck. And a good comeback there. It's 3-1.
I think he had to take that one because I'm not even sure he saw it.
And it's full now, 3-2.
And sometimes you got to cut down a little stride against a guy who's throwing this hard. Either you take that leg kick completely out of the equation, or you get it started just a little bit quicker.
And as a baseball fan, it's fun to watch this guy pitch. As a hitter, when he's bringing it at 102, that part's not so fun.
Here's the shortstop now, Jose Reyes. As this is popped foul behind the plate, it's strike one. Bases are empty here with two men out. A swinging bunt out in front of the plate. Perez scoops it up. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. A run for the Jays on the solo homer. We played three full. It's the Phillies 8 and the Blue Jays 1. Adrian Beltre is ready here as we begin the top of the fourth.
Well, guys, they jumped out to that big lead early on in this game, but you really can't get comfortable. You have to keep putting pressure on.
Hit sharply on the ground to the left, and that's a base hit. So a little first pitch swing in there as he's on to kick off the inning.
Man, these guys have been aggressive here early in the count. Some people think, oh, you might want to take a pitch to start in that bat. And sometimes that's great, and it works out for a lot of people. But what you should be thinking is, I got to swing at strikes, and I got to get my pitch. And if it happens to come on the first pitch, let it rip.
Fly ball out to straightaway right field. Mendoza is there, and he'll bring this one in.
This is a guy that doesn't really have great velocity, so when he elevates the fastball, it can lead to big problems. He gets away with it this time, though.
Brock Holt will dig in. He doubled his last time.
Boy, he had a great at-bat last time up, and he'll look for another pitch he can drive right here.
Lifted the other way to left center. Saunders is under it. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away.
Now batting.
Freddie Galvis stands into the box. He's 0 for 2 so far in this one. Line toward the gap in left center. Green is there, and they breeze through this half inning as the side is retired. Phillies down on just four pitches, and it remains an 8-1 ball game. Everett Cabrera is set to lead us off in the home half of the fourth inning.
Well, you know, they've fallen behind by quite a bit in the early going here, so they need a good inning here to get them back in the game.
Hit hard down the line. And a reach to his backhand, but he can't come up with it, and the leadoff man's aboard. Edwin Encarnacion is into the box. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. Now a slider, and he gets ahead of him here 0-1.
Yeah, the best way to neutralize this guy's power, just keep putting pitches right there.
Way late, and he's in there easily at second.
And there's some managers out there who'd say, we're already down a few runs here early. Let's not take too many chances on the base pass, but not this guy. He's not afraid to give his guys free rein out there, and this time it works out for him.
And he'll make it up to third safely here with one away.
Adam
LaRoche is the batter now as he looks at a ball of 1-0. Grounder hit hard down the first baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. One run, two hits, one error thus far for Toronto. And they'll go off speed here as this pitch misses. It's 2-1. 3-1.
Well, I think it's time to attack now because these guys haven't been in too many good hitters' counts. This is where you need to pounce.
Bounce to first. Oh, and he has some trouble with it. And the effort pays off as he's able to recover and get the second out of the inning.
Oh, I think they might have had a shot at getting that guy at the plate. But once this ball is bobbled, you forget about that. He'll just take the sure out at first and let that run come in to score.
Josh Donaldson will stand in for the second time now as he looks at a called strike. It's nothing and one. And this catches the zone as well. It's 0-2 now.
Some would say he's showing good patience here.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. So one run, one hit, no errors, and no one left on base. We played four full. It's the Phillies 8, the Blue Jays 2. Brandon Jordan heads for the box to start off the fifth in this one. A couple of righties starting to loosen now in the bullpen.
Jordan.
To short, hit hard. And that's in there for a base hit, his third hit of the game.
And he's got to be feeling pretty good about this afternoon so far. That's three at-bats,
three base hits.
Ben Revere ready for another at bat now. He's 2-for-3 so far.
Yeah, and you can bet he'd love to get himself that third hit. Those are the kind of games that puts a little extra pep in your step.
Chopped weakly up the first base line, and he'll just step on first here to take the sure out.
Yeah, you know, I think if you're more than a step or two away from the bag, your best bet is just to go to second with this ball. Here, he just takes a little too much time getting to the base to have a realistic shot at two.
Sends it in the air to deep left field. Saunders going back, but he can't get to this one. It's off the wall. The run scores from second. Now a 9-2 ball game.
It's kind of a surprise to me that he wouldn't try to go for two on this play. I don't know if he got caught up in his home run trot a little bit too early or what. He's going to wind up on first base here with a single off the wall.
Michael Franco steps in with one in, one out, and one on here in the inning. But the runner's back easily.
Keeping him close.
Burley comes set. Here comes the first pitch. Swing and a liner toward the gap in left center. And he'll lay out to make a spectacular catch. Wow.
You know, I don't care what they tell you about these artificial turf fields. This one's tough on the ribs. You see him sprawl out for this one, and that's a tough landing right there. It's a great play, but he might have a rug burn or two as well.
Into the box, Darren Ruff. Liner towards second. Again, a nice clean base hit, his third of the game.
Yeah, he's swinging a pretty hot bat. 3-for-4 now after the base hit. And that wasn't a little bleeder. That ball was smoked.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre, as he's swinging first pitch and sends a line drive out to left center. That's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second is in to score. And a relay to the plate. The tag by Navarro, but it's too late as the run scores.
This is a guy you don't want to make a mistake to with runners on base, because when you do, he normally does something like this. This is a bolt right here. You could hang your laundry on this one, and it's going to wind up scoring two.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez. And I believe they'll say he broke the plane, as yes, he did. It's ruled a strike. That look says it all in the third base dugout.
That's not the look of a guy who's going to be sleeping well tonight, is it?
Lifted in the air out towards left center. After it is Saunders. He's not going to get it. And the two-out rally continues. And the runner from second is in to score. And he will pull into second with an RBI double.
I got to tell you, I love the way this guy just lets it rip. Ahead in the count, behind in the count. It really doesn't matter to this guy. He's just going to go up, hack it, and he drives in a run right here as he just drills this one for two bases.
Here's Brock Holt now, as he'll swing at the first pitch and ground it foul off to the right. It's strike one. He's ready. Here's the 0-1. And he powers a cut fastball by him that time, and he's in charge now, nothing in two.
Tough pitches here, back to back. And now he's not going to give him anything good with a runner at second base.
Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Mendoza giving chase, makes the catch, and that'll retire the side. So it's four runs. Deionner Navarro comes to the plate as we get started here in the bottom of the fifth.
Well, they've got some work to do here, but there's still a lot of time left in this game. So just chip away, chip away.
Breaking ball for a strike, 0-1. The pitch count there, one pitch into his fifth inning of work. Not much of a concern, I wouldn't imagine.
Yeah, it shouldn't be. He hasn't had any real overtaxed innings, so he should be fine for the time being.
Gets on top of one here and chops it foul right at home plate. 0-2 count. Here's the pitch. In under the hands with a fastball. It's 1-2. Oh, and he's really got the strikeout pitch working now as he notches number 9 in the ball game.
Not only has he rung up a lot of strikeouts, but he still hasn't walked a batter to this point. So his control has been really, really spot on so far.
In now, Victor Mendoza. Chop foul right at home plate at strike one. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. And a pitch up and in, keeping him honest. 1-1. Oh, they have him looking awfully confused up there right now. It's 1-2.
And now he's made most of the hitters inside conscious. And, of course, that opens up the outside corner when he has to go there.
And he struck him out. The 10th victim sat down on strikes thus far.
Well, not only is that 10 strikeouts now, but I'll tell you what, we've still got a few innings to go here. He keeps throwing the way he is, he can make that number really interesting by the time this one's through.
Michael Saunders stands in looking to put the bat on the ball for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. And now a swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate. It's strike one.
Got in his kitchen big time right there.
I got the count. Now he breaks out the hook here. Good for strike two.
And this is part of why he's had a lot of success so far. He's done a lot of work on the edges and stayed out of the middle of the strike zone.
Pulled high in the air out to right field. Jordan will get there, and he puts it away to retire the side. Blue Jays go down in order, and this one rolls on. It's 12-2. Chad Jenkins will come on now to try and sort this mess out, as he'll likely be asked to go at least a few innings here. Freddy Galvis will be the first one to greet him here, as he'll be forced to turn around and hit from the left side now.
When you're 0-3 in a game already, I think you're really happy to see a new pitcher in this ballgame. Maybe something will change for him.
Hit on the ground down the first baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-1. Another one fouled off, and he's quickly behind 0-2. Into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. High in the air out to center field. Moving under it, Green. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone.
Now batting. And this is all about taking charge out there. That's the center fielder's ball if he can get there. So he calls everybody off, and he makes the play easily.
Brandon Jordan will stand in again as we flash you back to the early stages of this ball game. There were fans still finding their seats as he launched his second home run of the game, as he was off to a fast start indeed. First pitch on its way. High in the air and deep to left center field. Green looks up. And this ball is gone. No chance to make a play on that one. So a solo shot here to left center field. His third home run of the ball game, as this lead got even wider.
Well, we wondered what he'd have to do for an encore. Here it is, his third home run of the ball game. He's having an afternoon to remember so far.
As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. Hit down the line at first, but this will get foul for strike two. He's ready. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Weakly hit towards first. LaRoche fields it cleanly, and he'll take this to the bag himself, and there are two away now.
And that's what the two-seam fastball will do for you. Running away, not just for strikeouts. Here he gets him to hit it on the ground for an easy out.
Striding into the box, Drew Stubbs. He singled his last time up. First pitch hacking here, and that's the first strike. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Running hard, he's digging for second. And he'll pull into second with his fourth hit of the ball game.
Now batting, shortstop, Michael Franco.
Michael Franco comes forward for another shot after being robbed of a hit in his last at-bat.
Yeah, it was an absolute showstopper. All you can do is get back up there and try to hit the ball hard once again.
Grounded to short. Throw on to LaRoche is going to be in time, and the inning is over. Phillies will have to be content with just the one. 9-1-2 scheduled to hit in the home half of the sixth. The Phillies lead it 13-2. Harold Green will come forward now to start out their half of the sixth, and they've found it rough sailing against this starter so far, as he's yielded just two hits through the first five.
Not too many hard hit balls there either. He's had them off balance all game.
First pitch misses here to the leadoff man in the inning. The number nine hitter in the lineup, it's ball one. That'll be a souvenir, and the count will move to 1-1. Very high, 2-1.
Yeah, he's not really getting on top of that curveball right now. That's going to get him into trouble if he keeps leaving it up there like that.
And he wouldn't have made contact with that one with an oar. It's 2-2. Boy, that changeup's had him eaten out of his hand.
Oh, and they've been falling all over themselves trying to get it. But you've just got to know that that's not going to be a strike. It looks like it is, but it isn't.
And all through this winning streak of theirs, we've seen some great starting pitching. And this has been another very good performance. Good enough to most likely keep that winning streak going.
And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good.
And this might be just what the crowd needs to get off their hands a little bit. Last thing you want to do on the mound is hit a guy and have the crowd come to life against him.
Everett Cabrera will stand in. A strikeout victim his first time, and then a base hit last time around. And forget about the double play now, as he'll move up to second here on the wild pitch.
And you wonder if sometimes he was just getting a little too preoccupied out there with the speed at first base, and he totally loses focus on the guy at the plate. And now that essentially is going to work like a stolen base, and he's in the scoring position now on the wild pitch.
Two runs on two hits. One error thus far for Toronto. 2-1. He's fallen behind now. 3-1.
You figure he should get something good to hit here. They don't want to walk him and put him on for the heart of the order.
That's in there, and it'll run the count to full. 3-2.
That is one of the best he's thrown this afternoon.
Hit hard on the ground at third. And a sliding try there at third, but it skips by him, a base hit. The runner from second scores as they inch a bit closer. Edwin Encarnacion will dig in now. He struck out and lined out in his first two at-bats. And they start him out away with a called strike. And he falls behind 0-2. Chop foul at the plate and will do it again. Runner at first here, one man out. Did a good job to shorten up and protect the plate, and he'll have another shot at it here. Now a swing and a fly ball. Jordan sprinting after it, but no chance to run it down. It's a foul ball. Skied into straightaway right. Jordan has it in his sights. And he makes the catch for the second out.
You know, that's the thing with throwing a fastball as hard as he does. It makes fly balls travel that much farther off the path. And this thing gets out there a long ways before it finally gets tracked down.
He's set. Here it comes. Adam LaRoche is in with two away now as he looks at a called strike one.
And you know, if you're going to challenge a guy up in the zone with a fastball, why not do it on the first pitch? A lot of times he's going to be taken anyway, and you just bought yourself a strike that you can now...
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. So one run on one hit, no errors, and a runner left. We're through six full. Philadelphia's on top, 13-3. Back here at Rogers Center in Toronto. This one pretty much all over, but the shouting as we check our game summary to see how we've gotten to where we are. Steve Delabarre will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Darren Ruff will stand in as we'll flash you back to the second inning as you get a look at this key three-run home run. Darren Ruff. Now some definite signs of life in that Toronto bullpen. Both a lefty and a right-hander begin to throw. And he got him out in front that time. Strike one.
That splitter, it's only coming in around 86, but it's really falling through the zone.
Grounder down the line at third. Donaldson's there. And the throw to first is in time, so the leadoff man is gone here to start inning number seven.
Third baseman number 29, Adrian Beltre.
Adrian Beltre will step in. He doubled home a couple this last time.
And remember, he jumped all over that first pitch, so don't be surprised if he does it here again.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. In tight here with the first pitch fastball that's 1-0. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Saunders on the move, but he can't make the play as it finds the outfield grab. And he will beat the throw into second as he slides in safely with a one-out double.
Now batting, catcher, Salvador Perez.
Salvador Perez stands in, looking to build off that RBI double from his last plate appearance. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Smoked on the ground, left side. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit.
The batter, number 34, designated hitter.
Brock Holt will stand in. He flew out his last time up.
And I'm sure he'd like a base hit right now here of any sort. But, hey, another fly ball wouldn't be all that bad because he should be able to drive in a run with a sacrifice fly.
Swing and a little blooper to center. Green coming in. And that's the second out of the inning. And even with two away now, that ball just didn't get out there deep enough, so they'll hold him at third base.
It just didn't get enough of that one to get that run home, so that's probably a wise decision to hold at third.
Freddy Galvis gets a shot now with two men on and two away here in inning number seven.
And we'll see here if he can come through. It can be discouraging to see opportunities like this late in a ball game go untapped.
Out in front of it, strike one. The 0-1 delivery. Grounded up the first baseline. And a heck of an effort over there at first, but it'll be for naught as this is a foul ball. Protecting on 0-2, so we'll do it again. Looking to put him away. Here's the 0-2. Fought off at the plate, and we'll do it again. Here's the 0-2. He got him. And exhale as he's out of the jam and the inning is over. Phillies leave a couple, but you can forgive them as they still hold an enormous lead. Josh Donaldson will stand in for the third time now, still without a hit, so that streak could be in a bit of jeopardy.
And I think that's in the back of his mind, but it's not something he's really focused on. He just wants to get up there and put a good swing on the ball.
Right there for strike one.
And if he's getting tired, it's not showing in his slider. That pitch is still as tight as it was in the second inning.
Here's one that misses high. It's 1-1.
Josh Donaldson is, of course, one of the greatest players in the game today. But before he was a pro, he had a really nice college career at Auburn, the same program that has turned out other greats such as Frank Thomas, Bo Jackson, and Timmy Hudson.
To two balls and two strikes now. Hit the other way out toward right field. Jordan is there, one away.
Now batting.
And you know, he really doesn't have to throw that changeup all that much for it to be an effective pitch. And you can see what his breakdown is so far.
Deonner Navarro stands in for the third time now as he takes a look at a ball. It's 1-0. And that's in there for his strike, 1-1. And through 6 1/3, he's about to hit the 100 pitch mark now. 1-2 now as that one's fouled off. One out, nobody on.
Got him.
As he just continues to mow down these hitters, 13 strikeouts now.
Boy, and just a great call that time to turn to the changeup. That's one of those at the plate where you don't even wait for the umpire to make the call. You know you're a goner.
Now at the plate, Victor Mendoza. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Well, at the very least, he went down hacking. Striking out is one of the many frustrations that go along with hitting, and you have to accept that it's going to happen sometimes.
That's over, but low. It's a ball and a strike. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and it's 1-2.
Yeah, he's definitely still bringing it. It's the seventh inning, and we're still hearing the catcher's mitt snapping all the way up here.
Trying to strike him out for the third time. Good job to spoil that one away, and he stays alive. Got him swinging, and that will end the inning. 1-2-3 go the Blue Jays. And they remain well behind. Brandon Jordan will stride in again as he looks to join a very elite list. We take you back to earlier. This was home run number 3 in the ballgame as he'll try and join just a select few with 4 home runs in a single game. First delivery to him on the way. Chop foul at the plate, strike one. Oh and one, here it comes. Fastball misses inside, it's even at one. One and two as he chases the slider.
Oh, man, what a perfect pitch right there in a perfect spot. And that's exactly how you have to attack a guy like this. He wasn't even close on that pitch.
Here he comes on a ball and two strikes. And did he go around? No, he did not. Ball two.
If he would have swung at that,
You would have never heard the end of it.
And this will miss down low in the dirt, so he's worked it full now at 3-2.
He tried to get him to bite on that pitch, but it was way out of the zone there. It didn't even tempt him. Now he'll need to make a much better pitch here on a 3-2 count.
Takes this the other way to right. Mendoza is there to put it away for out number one.
Well, any dreams of a four-home run game are probably out the window now. I don't think he'll get another shot, but still, it's been a game to remember for that man. No doubt about it.
Striding in once again, Ben Revere. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. Saunders is in pursuit, but he doesn't have a chance. It's over his head. And he is in to second base with a double, his third hit this afternoon.
Center fielder number 16.
Drew Stubbs steps in with four hits already in this one and looking for number five here.
Well, he's just stroking it, Matt. I was watching him earlier in batting practice, and he looked good, but I didn't know it was going to be this good.
And this sails right by the catcher Navarro. It'll be a wild pitch. And he is safe at third as he moves up on what's likely to be ruled a wild pitch.
Yeah, and then one pitch later, he basically turns that double into a triple, as that's going to be ruled a wild pitch.
A man at third with one away. Two balls, no strikes now, batting with one out and a runner at third. Well hit the other way, and it's into the gap. Notch one in the score column as a runner from third crosses the plate. The relay throw, and he is in there with an RBI triple.
Well, unfortunately, this is probably going to be his last at-bat. This triple will give him three legs of the cycle, so unless his guys really go to work, he won't have a chance to finish it off. But either way, he's had a tremendous ball game. Misses the capper right here.
Stepping in now, Michael Franco. As he'll swing and hit this one hard but foul off to the left and out of play. One out and a runner on third. Ripped down the line, but this will wind up a foul ball, strike two. That misses, one and two.
Very tempting up there, but that's also a pitch that a lot of guys will pop up. So that's a nice job of laying off.
And he lays off a pitch outside as they draw even at 2-2.
All right, no more hoping he's going to chase. On 2-2 now, you got to come up with your best pitch right here because this is a definite strikeout situation.
Struck him out. And now they'll likely need a base hit to get that runner home from third.
Boy, and they've had his number all through this one. He's now 1-for-6 in this ballgame. Man, that hurts.
Darren Ruff steps in and perhaps looking to drive another one out of the park just like he did in the second. They'll try and entice him with a high fastball, but he wouldn't commit. It's ball one.
And not only was that way high, but you've got to be careful not to airmail one over your catcher's head.
Oh, and he gets a hold of this one as it's in the air to deep left. Does he have another one? He does. It's another home run. It's a two-run shot to straightaway left. His second home run of the game as the blowout continues.
Oh, whatever these guys are putting in their pregame meal, you can be darn sure they're getting the same setup tomorrow. That's 5 home runs as a team now. I mean, these guys are feeling it up there.
Todd Redmond will come on now in a mop-up role, as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger.
Redmond.
Here's the third baseman, Adrian Beltre. Swing and a miss on a ball in the dirt, and it's strike one.
And after that swing, you get the feeling he might just keep that pitch in his back pocket until he needs it again.
Now this one is blasted to left field, and there's no doubt about it. Back-to-back jacks. So a solo home run off the bat of Adrian Beltre. Home run number 15 for him thus far, as they just continue to pour it on here.
Well, they went to the bullpen to get that right-handed reliever, hoping that that would give him the right-on-right advantage. Well, guess again. He gets a pitch out over the plate, and he turns that thing right around. That was no cheapie either.
Here's the catcher, Salvador Perez.
Salvador.
As the first pitch to him is taken low and away for ball one. Oh, could it be 3 in a row? Saunders ranging back. Out of here. And how about that? Back to back to back home runs. A solo shot here to left. 8th home run on the season for him, as this lead got even wider.
And as a manager, you always hope you can get some power production out of the middle of your order. But this is taking it a bit too far. Back to back to back home runs.
The batter,
here's Brock Holt now.
Designated hitter.
As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. 2 out, nobody on. He can't hold on there as he swings and misses on a pitch in the dirt, and he's down 0-2 now. Seems like they're showing a lot of faith in this guy, leaving him out there.
And I think you appreciate that as a pitcher, but sometimes when you don't have it, you don't have it. Looks like this is going to be one of those times.
And that's in for his second hit of the afternoon.
Just amazing what this guy's done with the bat this year. I mean, even when he's in a 2-strike hole, he still finds a way to come through.
Freddy Galvis, ready to take another shot, went down on strikes his last time up.
It was a pretty big strikeout, too, because he had a chance to drive in a run, so I'm sure he's going to be thinking about that missed opportunity for a little while.
He pulls this one into right. Mendoza there to put it away and finally put an end to the inning. 9 men come to the plate, however, 5 of them score. Not too many more shots left. Home half of the 8th coming up. Phillies lead this one 18-3. Michael Saunders is set to take some more swings. He homered back in the 3rd inning.
Michael.
And a high strike to begin the at-bat. It's 0-1. Any question in your guys' minds about bringing the starter back here for the 8th inning?
I would have thought 7 innings would have been enough, but knowing this guy, he may have talked his manager into letting him stay and go out there for one more inning.
Got him. And that's number 15 for the ball game. At the plate, Harold Green, as the switch hitter will take his cuts left-handed here.
You know, and this is his power side from the left side. He's got quite a bit more pop in that bat hitting left-handed.
Now a fastball that's taken close that time, but it's 1-1. Foul right at the plate. The count moves now to 1-2. And we're going to have a quick stoppage here as a beach ball has made its way into right field. Check swing grounder to the right side. Underhanded flip, and the throw is not going to be in time as he's able to reach base safely.
Number 7, Jose Reyes.
Jose Reyes comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. A look here at the hits per side here in the late going. And that's cut on and missed as Reyes falls behind here, nothing and two. Very difficult to get on top of a pitch when it's coming in that high.
Darn near impossible when it's coming at you in the high 90s. You just can't get your hands up there fast enough to stay on top.
Oh, and he misses the stop sign there as he heads for the plate. Tag from Perez. He's out at the plate.
Yeah, now in hindsight, you could have had runners at second and third with one out, but they roll the dice. They're trying to pick up that run from first, and it winds up not working out for them.
Into the box now, Everett Cabrera, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Right by him here, and he's set up for another strikeout here, the count to 0-2.
And this deep into the ballgame, you get the feeling that he's not going to keep getting away with pitches like that, especially when they're up in the zone.
A little late on the fastball, but he's able to spoil that one off, and he'll get another chance. Nothing in two count, and the pitch. Swing and a liner back through the box. And that's through into center field. Base hit. In to score, the runner from third.
This is quickly becoming a situation where you'd like your guy to hit the complete game, but once you get into that 115, 120 range, you have to be concerned.
And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Who pulled the string and had him way out in front, a ball and a strike. Takes a look at a changeup there, and it's a ball and two strikes now. Chopped foul right at home plate. Trying to strike him out for the second time. Tap fouled at home plate. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. The 1-2 pitch. And he'll try to entice him with the changeup here, but it dips below the knees. It's 2-2.
Such a good at-bat right here. When you can grind out.
And the throw to first is there. The inning is over. So one run on three hits, no errors, and a runner left. We've played eight full. The Phillies lead it 18-4. Matt Stites will come on now in a mop-up role as he'll just try and keep this deficit from growing any larger. Brandon Jordan comes to the plate looking to do something only a handful of players have ever done. Hit four home runs in a single game. And this will make its way into center field for a base hit, and the leadoff man's aboard now to open the ninth. And he's out trying to stretch it into a double, so a costly mistake here leading off the inning.
This is going to turn into one of those no harm, no foul situations out there on the mound. He serves out the base hit here, but that guy's thinking two all the way, and it doesn't work out for him.
Here's Ben Revere. A little tapper. And the throw to LaRoche is in time. Two gone. Coming to the plate now, Drew Stubbs. And all eyes are on him as he needs a home run to complete the cycle.
And he knows it too, guys. Let's see if he can send a jolt through one right here.
Oh, and he leaves the fastball up there. Mistake in location. He is going to pay for it dearly as that ball is sent over the wall. A home run. A solo shot here to left. Home run number 5 on the year as the blowout continues.
If you're going to finish off a cycle, you may as well do it with the long ball. You had to figure he'd be swinging for the fences when he got up there, and sure enough, he puts a charge into this one to put his name in the record books.
The batter, number 7.
Into the box, Michael Franco. As he'll go after the first pitch and bounce one foul for the first strike. The 0-1 pitch. Swing and a ball hit fairly well, heading high and deep toward right center. And he will get there as he had to cover a lot of ground to make that play. And that ends the inning. So one run here on two hits, with the big blow being the home run. No errors and no one left. We'll head now to the bottom of the ninth. Philly. Lewis Coleman will come in now working with a huge lead, so he'll just look to get some work in here.
Lewis Coleman.
Adam LaRoche will stand in now to begin their half of the ninth in a game that was decided long, long ago.
Yeah, this is mop-up time out there right now. But hey, these at-bats still count against your batting average, so you can't go up there and just mail it in. You've got to see this through right to the end of the game.
And another foul ball. Looking for the strikeout. Here's the 0-2 pitch. Struck him out as his woes continue, as that's his third strikeout of the game.
And this is where the scouting report really pays off. I mean, sometimes you just got to go looking for a soft spot in the guy's zone, and they found one there.
Josh Donaldson will stand in. He flew out his last time up. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. Swing and a liner, but this is a foul ball. Swing and a ball line hard towards short, but right at the shortstop for the second out.
Now batting.
Hey, so much catcher for having to protect on an 0-2 count. This guy takes a huge rip at this ball and squares it up nicely. Just a tough break for him that he hit it right at someone.
Here's the catcher, Deonner Navarro, batting left-handed here as he takes a look at strike one.
And you know, this is a guy that loves the ball down and in. It's one of the locations he really covers well, so they're going to want to mix their spots here.
A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Very weakly on the ground. That rolls foul, so a good job to fight it off and stay alive. And he'll try to get him to chase the fastball there, but he lays off. 1-2.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking on the final out, so that's a tough pitch to lay off.
And this is hit hard up the middle. On to first, and that will seal matters here this afternoon.
Well, there's another good win for these guys. That pushes their streak up to 5 in a row now, and it's been a total team effort. Good pitching, good hitting, good defense. They're doing it all right now.
Well, this one pretty much over before it started, as we give you a final look at the line score here in what turned out to be a blowout victory. And guys, I think you might agree there's little doubt that the star of this afternoon's contest was this man, Drew Stubbs. Take a snapshot of that. He's our top player of the game.
And you know, a cycle is about the equivalent of a no-hitter for a pitcher. It's one of the rarest things you can do on a baseball field. So no doubt he's going to wind up our player of the game.
So that just about does it. For EK, Psycho, and the crew, I'm Matt Vaskirjian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, get those smartphones and tablets.